So, next speaker will be Mr. Kumar Malik from Nepal. As we know, the smart hydrogen power is very useful for distributed energy supply. So that is for grid connection policy for micro mini hydrogen power. It will be very important. So Mr. Malik will bring us about Nepal experiences and practices. Please,
thank you. Very good morning, all of you. This is Jeevan Kumar Malik from Nepal, and the conference guide over there in your desk. Then my name is mentioned, Kumar Malik. So I'm the same person, believe me, Jeevan Kumar Malik. The another Ramkha Dedal, he is Executive Director of Alternative Energy Promotion Center, APC, and which is a nodal government agency for the promotion of renewable energy in Nepal. And under the umbrella of APC, RERL is a UNDP JEP supported project, which is providing technical assistance to AEPC. So coming to the topic of presentation, development of grid connection policy for micro hydro plant in Nepal. Probably this may be very anything for you, because the capacity wise, this is a less than, I will be talking less than 1 megawatt plant size. But let me tell you, the impact of this 1 megawatt, lesser than 1 megawatt, is very high, at least in our context. So far, we have provided electricity access to around 4 million people. And the history of development of micro hydro, mini hydro in Nepal is since 1970. But nowadays, many of micro, mini hydro are left abandoned because of the grid extension. So this is a now need for the grid connection of the micro, mini hydro. So I would like to start my presentation with two sayings from the gentleman. It's self-explanatory. You can read, the less we have to do with the government, the happier we are. I will link this saying with the conclusion of my presentation. This is a saying from one of the Indian micro hydropower developer. And another one is from IFC official. The regulation can provide a fertile ground, but the regulation does not make a market. So in fact, I have copied this from one of the gentlemen. And this is all I will be talking. Micro hydro, transfer electricity to the grid, and generate the revenue back from the grid. So coming to the introduction, this is all about the overview of Nepal. Total population is around 28 million, over 28 million in fact. And access to electricity is 76.3%. And net energy import is 15.74% of total use. Out of 76.3% of electrification, 15% has been contributed from the off-grid projects like micro hydro, solar, biomass, biogas. So far we have installed approximately 1200 of micro mini hydro plants. Capacity ranges from 10-20 kilowatts up to 500 kilowatts, 600 kilowatts. And so far we have installed more than 700,000 solar home systems and 3000 ISPS institutional solar power systems, and wind and biogas are in progress. And in context of energy consumption situation, traditional means the firewood is 77%, renewable 3%, and commercial 20%. This is data taken from the economic survey of Ministry of Finance. And this is another right hand side picture. Residential, in our residential case, it is 80.36%. So you can imagine the development of our country. Most of the developed countries have more energy consumption in the industrial and commercial sector rather than in residential. So you can imagine the development rather than explaining more. So in terms of energy access in Nepal, out of total 5.43 million households in Nepal, this is the figures. Firewood 64.5 60 4% and other some of other figures are there. This will be available in the internet. I'm not going in detail. And the, in terms of potential in our country, it's 83 gigawatt approximately is hydro capacity, and technically feasible is 42 gigawatt. And solar we have 6.8 hour per day of sunshine, and solar incoming solar radiation is 4.5 square kilowatt hour per square kilometer per square meter per day. And wind is approximately 3 gigawatt, and similarly other technology. And in terms of micro hydro off grid systems, these are the some of the things we are using: governing system, excitation system, protection system, metering, and switchgear. And in terms of governing system, we have hydromechanical, electromechanical, and ELC. But in our case, we use ELC, electronic load controller. Let me tell you that, in fact, the grid connection with the governor is very, very easy. And it is used so far in all the country and everywhere. But the grid connection with the ELC, electronic load controller, is a little bit technically challenged. And the ELC, I can say, why we prefer the ELC is only because of the cost effective. Around in our country, the ELC is available in 2000, no, in our 30,000 means $300 to 200, maximum $300, and you can find it in, even in 200 or less than $200. So it is a much more cost effective than the hydromechanical governor or the governor, air compressed governor nowadays used in the hydropower. So this is the reason we are using ELC. And the ELC, electronic load control, is nothing but this manage the power between the generation, dummy load, and consumer load. This is the ELC schematic we are using, the technical, some of the technical things we are using. This is the generation side, this is the consumer side, consumer load, community load, and if let's say there is 100 kilowatt and consumer load is only 60 kilowatt, so by the means of this ELC, we divert remaining 40 kilowatt to the dummy load. Dummy load could be heating of the water or air heaters. And we use this 6-channel ELC. Previously we were using 3-channel ELC, but nowadays we are using 6-channel ELC for the better power quality, lesser harmonics, total harmonic distortions. And some of the features of ELC we are using is Drupe concept. This is especially for the interconnection of interconnection between two micro hydro systems. And ELC working in parallel, this means interconnection of two micro hydro systems. And the generator excitation systems we are using, this is AVR, similar to the larger hydropowers. And protection systems, these are the protection systems we are using nowadays. Metering and display systems, this is also common to the larger hydropower systems. And switchgear, we are not going for the VCV or ACV kind of things. So we use simple MCCB, molded case circuit breaker, for the isolation of circuit if any fault occurs. So again, because of the cost, lesser cost. And some single diagram we have used for the grid connection, some of the figures for PLC based control panel. And this is again, this analysis is for the off-grid micro hydro systems. That is again less than 1 megawatt systems. You can see the analysis here. This is a curve. Here the power is insufficient at around 7 p.m. because of the mostly loads are residential. So for this we do load shedding. There is no any other option. If it would be grid connected, then this power can be drawn from the grid. And remaining time, this is a waste of energy. We are generating the energy from the micro hydro, but we are doing the waste in the dummy load. So there is a need of grid connection now to utilize this percentage of energy. And this is not a small percentage, 72% is useless, and we are only utilizing 28%. So I can say that plant factor of micro hydro, off-grid micro hydro, mini hydro is very, very less. So again, need of grid connection is defined by this curve. in terms of income and expenditure of one, this is carried out from the one of the case study of microaggregate system. This is in terms of Nepalese rupees convertible, 106 Nepalese rupees is $1. So from the domestic, we have approximately $270. This is monthly, and in usage means not consumptive use, productive use of energy from the micro hydro. Could be a commercial shop, could be milling, could be poultry farming, anything. And penalty, sometimes we impose the penalty who don't pay the tariff, monthly tariff. So this is the total income, and in terms of expenditure is high. So this again, why we are struggling with the sustainability of micro hydro, because of the less revenue generation. If we would be able to connect to the grid, we believe that micro hydro would be more sustainable in terms of revenue generation as well. So in terms of cash flow of grid micro hydro, you can see the overall, the average one is increasing with the range of capacity. So economy of scale works here. The conclusion of this curve is economy of more larger the plant is, more revenue generation from that plant. And the cash flow analysis, again, with end usage means productive use of energy, there is more revenue generation. Without end use, very less. With access to road, it is more, because access to road have more potential of end usage, kind of commercial shops. So you can utilize the micro-hydro generated electricity in the commercial shops. And without access, less. And with meter, this is again with meter and without meter because of the awareness in the community. And greater than 10 years, we have very less. And nowadays, it is very high because nowadays we are working with the larger capacity of micro mini-hydro plants. And, sorry. Policy, how we have breakthrough of this policy of grid connection of micro mini hydro to the utility. Let me tell you, when we approached, this is 3 years back, when we approached to utility just referred micro hydro as a candle. Hey candle guy, why you come here to connect to the grid? This is the situation in the 3 years back. Now the utility accepted and we have formalized the technical standard and everyone is accepted, and we are doing piloting of the two micro hydro projects for the grid connection. And how we achieved is that this is the utility, Nepal Electricity Authority is a utility authority, and off grid we are responsible for the promotion of micro mini hydro. So this is the again need, many things I already covered. Standalone suffer from the capacity inadequacy during the morning and peak, and whereas some have surplus capacity, we have seen in the curve. And overall plant factor is very, very low, less than 30%. And it is extending again the utility, NEA, National Nepal Electricity Authority, is expanding grid very rapidly. And we don't have, let me remind you, we don't have any master plan. So we established the micro hydro plant, the next year the grid approaches and micro hydro left abandoned. Interconnected mini grid with the possibility of ultimate connection to the national grid. And this is the steps we follow to break through of the policy for the grid connection micro hydro. A consultant was hired to prepare technical standard, AEPC finalized the document. Technical standard for NEA to review, and in the utility NEA there was a review team forwarded it to again the joint working team between NEA and AEPC was formed, and the review team forwarded it to the review and finalized the standard to financial NEA board, and finally the NEA board approved grid connection policy for micro mini hydro on 19th July. And these are some technical parameters we have finalized in our technical standards. There will be synopsis in the ICSSP website. All these are covered there. I'm skipping because of the time limitation. This was the main problem utility were asking us. This is islanding network. They were asking of the safety concern. like once the there is a grid failure or load shedding in the grid, the micro hydro should isolate from the grid as soon as possible. Otherwise, micro hydro may backfeed to the grid, and that may be hazardous to the line crew or maintenance guy. So we have solved this from the Rockoff relay, rate of change of frequency relay. This is commonly used in large hydropower as well. So some of the technical parameters again, and these are the some commercial points we have done with the PPA. Take or pay clause shall not be applied in both parties. If micro hydro is generating more power, then there is no obligation from the utility to take the surplus power as well. And some of the others, terms and conditions. And the PPA rate now finalized is approximately 8 US cents for dry season, that is from April to November, sorry, November to April, and remaining month, 8 months, 4.7 US cents per unit of electricity. And this is some situations you can observe, especially this column and this column. This is across the region. I have taken this from the SP8. So many countries still doesn't have this kind of policy. And some of the barriers, the technical standard agreed by NEA, still we have seen some challenges. After the piloting, we are going to correct some of our technical standards, like we have now approved CTPT accuracy class would be 0.5, and the accuracy class of 0.5 CTPT is very costly. So we are going to take it to accuracy class of 1, which would be cheaper, and it will be cost effective solution for the grid connection. And again, we are facing load shedding in the grid. So load shedding is another barrier for the grid connection of micro hydro. And again, the ELC technology for the grid, compatible for the grid connection. And some of the crucial challenges, we have mainly the community-owned micro hydro. So community-owned micro hydro may not have capability to do all the PPA, power purchase agreement procedure, and application procedure for the grid connection. And some of the administrative, I'm speaking to your time limitation, and that's all. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Marisa, for your excellent presentation. You not only present about the policy for the connecting, but also some technology. I believe this is also very useful for our developing countries.